Minnesota. A great time to eat apples, to buy apples, and to go to apple orchards. I'm Mary Meyer from the University of Minnesota Extension. Today we're here at the Horticulture Research Center's Apple House, part of the Minnesota Landscape Arboretum, and we're going to talk about how you can identify what apple have you got growing in your home or garden. The first thing you want to consider is, when does it ripen? Early ripening apples in late August and September are going to be quite different varieties than ones that ripen in October. Some of our early Minnesota apples are Zestar and Sweet Tango or State Fair. Late ripening apples like Harrelson come in October, so time of ripening is critical. An apple is ripe when it has really dark seeds on the inside. They're almost dark brown or almost black in color, and all the starch has been converted to sugar, and you could tell when you taste the apple. So ripening time, first thing to consider with what apple do I have. The next thing is color. Obviously, what does the apple look like? We got a lot of red apples in Minnesota, but if you have a green apple or a yellow apple, that's going to clearly tell you what kind, or narrow down the kinds that it is. The next thing is the shape or the appearance of the apple. We have a Sweet Tango here that's kind of a big oblong apple, and here's a Macintosh. It's squat and flatter. There's also a bloom on this Macintosh apple that's kind of a glaucous coloring that when you rub it, it gets real shiny. So very characteristic of a Macintosh or Cortland. You don't have that same appearance here on the Sweet Tango. Sweet Tango, you have lenticels. These are spots or dots all over the apple. Don't have that on Macintosh. So color and appearance can help you identify your apple. Now let's go out to the apple orchard and we'll talk about the origin and age of an apple tree. So we're here in the orchard at the Horticulture Research Center, and we need to, in identifying your apple, we need to talk about how old is your apple tree and where did it come from. So the age of your tree, if it's a young tree, it's going to be smaller, and it's very likely a Honeycrisp or maybe a Zestar, a newer variety if it's a younger tree. If the tree is big and old and has a big, wide diameter to it, old, gnarly tree, it's very likely a Harrelson apple. Now, where did the tree come from? Did you plant it? Is it in an obvious planted place, maybe in the front of your property or a protected, or even in a small orchard? Then you're sure it's a planted tree. But if it's in an area where there's maybe some other things have grown up around it, or you're not sure whether somebody planted it, maybe it's a seedling. Maybe it grew up on its own. And if that's the case, it's going to be really hard to tell what that tree is, because it could be anything. It could be a wild apple that really isn't a named kind of apple at all. So we're going to look at the rootstock now with the scion, the good apple on the top, and the roots at the bottom. This bulge is where the two meet together. The good apple you want, and the rootstock that's tough and hardy. If the top should die, this tough, hardy rootstock can start growing, but it's a totally different apple, not necessarily as good as what we've got up here in the top. So that you have to remember, there are two things on your apple tree. The next thing to do in identifying your apple is take one of your apples to an orchard. Take it to the Horticulture Research Center, the Apple House, and compare your apple to what's in the grocery store or at an orchard. And that way you can kind of narrow it down as to what it may or may not be. And the last thing in identifying what apple you've got, if you want to spend a lot of money, you can send your apple to DNA testing services now. At the University of California, they're doing this. It costs several hundred dollars. They have several thousand apple varieties in there, and they may be able to tell you what apple definitively you have. ¶¶ So I hope we've given you some good tips and information on how to tell what apple variety you have. For more information, go to the website extension.umn.edu and click on Yard and Garden.